What's up, what's up, what's up? It's your boy DC the Cool back in another video. Today we are talking about the Bandai, Nintendo, and Microsoft event from last week. I needed a week just to recover from this nonsense. I literally was just, you understand how upset I was, how distraught I was. You know, it was god awful, okay? And I just playing Ghost, and, you know, just trying to recover from that nonsense because it was horrible. I was mad for quite some time, and I didn't have the energy to even put into a video to really even, you know, just go into a scathing rant. So took some time, thought about it clearly, and here we are now. So let's go ahead and start with the least worst to the worst. Least worst was Microsoft, actually. Microsoft was the least worst because the thing about it, their showcase was horrible and nothing looked next gen. The new Halo looked abysmal compared to what it should look for a next gen, you know, ninth generation game as a flagship main title to your series, to your, you know, console. Looked very bad. Looked like an early mid PS3 game. Did not like even a PS4 game, let alone a PS5/Series X game. Terrible. Most of the games had this toon shade, artistic style look, and it's just like, there's no excuse for this, man. Yeah, it's easy to get 4K 60 while the games look like that. That's inexcusable for all the money you have as a big name studio like you. That Halo game had $500 million as its budget. You know what other game had $500 million? A game called Destiny, which is, funny enough, created by the former developers of Halo. Graphically, Destiny, whether you like the game or not, looks amazing. That game looks beautiful. That game is clean with the graphics. You know what I mean? And the gameplay is good. And the online is smooth. The problem with the game was lack of content. Over the course of time, they rectified stuff like that, but it's one of those games of service type games. But at the end of the day, it was still a better game than what Halo has become, in my opinion. Some people disagree, and that's fine. But graphically, you can't see nothing about it. But at the end of the day, the only games they showed from the Xbox showcase that I was interested in and looked good to me was The Medium, the new Genesis Fantasy Star Online, which is way overdue because you play that game like I do. You know that that game graphically is old, outdated. The game's like 10 years old or something like that, and it looks abysmal as far as like graphically or whatever. The game is fun. So a new upgrade and look for that game is way overdue. So that's great. And there's one other one that looked pretty cool. I forget what it was. But two or three games don't cut the mustard. The game showcase for next gen, nobody's running to get next gen. If this is what you're delivering for next gen Xbox, there's no reason for somebody to run out and get it. I mean, other side of the Game Pass right now, you're looking spooky out here. We go ahead and go to Nintendo. Nintendo had the second worst one because they showed one game. The guy back side for Nintendo Mini. I understand Nintendo Mini is not going to be a 45 hour and a half showcase reel of great games and features for the Switch. I get that. But you still put a Nintendo Direct Mini. You still put Direct in the name. You didn't have to say Direct at all. This could have been on Instagram. This could have just been on YouTube as, you know, an uploaded trailer, an update, like you do every other game that you don't care, you know, care about to that level. Or people, I mean, because it's the internet. I won't say you don't care about, that's bad wording. It's the internet. You put something out there, it will be viral. If it's a big deal, it will be viral within a few hours. Sometimes less than that, depending on what it is. You don't need to get people's hopes up with that name, Nintendo Direct. You knew what you were doing. People were going to see it. People have been waiting for Shin Megami Tensei for quite some time. The fifth installment of this game was going to get its clout regardless of the fact. So for you to know it's just one game and waste our time for 8 minutes, that was a slap in the face. Because if this was any other year, Nintendo, y'all would have had an E3 press release or conference type of deal in June. You know, Nintendo Direct, you know, E3 style. Y'all haven't dropped anything. It's almost August. Y'all haven't released anything like that. And any other year, you would have had one. And I know people want to say, well, it's COVID. Give them a chance. Give them a break. Microsoft as well, you know, development times been cut in half. You know, people got work from home. It's COVID. Okay, I understand COVID. But we are not going to use COVID as a get-out-of-jail-free card. You knew for over a year this event was coming. COVID really didn't start taking off as far as a big deal and shutting down stuff until mid, late March. Okay. The showcase that y'all normally do was in June. Okay. So y'all knew and had plenty of time to have majority of stuff ready to go before June happened. All right. So I don't want to hear COVID as an excuse for Microsoft or Nintendo or Bandai, COVID ruined everything. No. Y'all knew and y'all had all this time to prep before COVID was even really a thing or known to be a big thing as it is now. You cannot use that as an excuse for why Halo looks bad, because y'all been in development for 4 or 5 years now, you know, since this game's been announced, and you can, and the game comes out in November. All right, how you gonna, how I forget the cat's name, but how you gonna come out and cap, oh well, the game's looking better every day, and you know, we got plenty of time before launch. It comes out in November. We're almost in August. That's what, 2 months? You know, three months? The graphics are one of the first things that you make for a new game. So this is how it looks 3 months before release. I'm scared for this game, for real. I mean, come on. At some point, you cannot keep making excuses. This is inexcusable for a system as powerful as you love bragging about. No, strongest system, strongest console ever. You know what I'm saying? More powerful than Xbox One X. More powerful than the PS4 Pro. You know, it looks like that. Come on, bro. Inexcusable. I'm not in the graphics horror, but there's no excuse for it looking that bad, though, honestly. You know what I mean? But Nintendo gets second place for the worst showing because they showed off one game and they have not shown anything else for the Switch or anything, an accessory, nothing thus far. First place goes to Bandai Namco. They should be ashamed of themselves. That, by far, was the worst gaming stream I have ever seen in my life. It was horrible. They literally introduced nothing new. Almost an hour for nothing new. Outside of a minute detail of, well, you can get this character in the mobile game for free when you pre-order this game. Nobody cares. Bro, mobile gaming during the COVID pandemic. Really? I cannot wait to go out there, run around, no mask on, playing a mobile game. Come on, man. This is ridiculous. I mean, all that stuff could have been shown again on the Instagram, on Twitter. It did not have to be some. Here's the worst part. They hyped that Play Anime Live event for over a month, or maybe a little over a month. Definitely was a month. For weeks, Play Anime Live, questions, games, Striker, all the hot games, you know, all these announcements, you know. They want to miss this. This, you know, prizes, giveaways. I'm like, they talk so much stuff about this event for it to be trash. The hosts were obviously reading from cue card or, you know, the teleprompter or whatever. They were bland as a box of cornflakes. You know what I mean? They were corny. You know, like, it was just so whack across the board, man. It was just so bad. I'm just like, I don't understand. What did you prove by this? What message did you get across? Just to tell us what we already knew? I mean, what were you gaining out of this? I just don't understand. What did this really do for anybody? That's why I want to know. What did this do for anybody?
So, at the end of the day, you know, if this is next gen, I'm good. At the end of the day, I mean, you guys can have it. I'm good. There was nothing I saw that made me interested in, well, for the most part. So, I'm going next gen. So, you know, the other stream has passed. Happened yesterday. I will be covering that pretty soon. So, that's it for me. Till next video. Catch you guys later. Like, share, subscribe. Peace out.